magnetic materials and crystalline magnetic materials have played an important role in the development of Pittsburgh industries for 100 years or so. And in particular, steel, silicon steels, are the materials that are used in large motors, they're used in power transformers. They've built a whole infrastructure based on these. And once materials like those find an infrastructure like that, it's very difficult to displace them. In recent years, in the past several decades, there's been knowledge that our energy demands are greater than our capacity to meet them with some of these materials. So there's been a lot of thought to how to make big power components more efficient. And that's where my materials come in. My work generally is in the area of magnetic materials, and I'm looking at things that are called metallomorphous nanocomposite materials. And metallomorphous nanocomposite materials are materials that we make in a amorphous or a glassy state because they have superior magnetic properties in that state. We make them that way by casting metal and cooling it at a very, very rapid rate. We cool metal at about 1,000,000 degrees per second. And at that rate of cooling, atoms don't have time to find positions in a crystalline lattice, and so the material remains amorphous or glassy. If we do it in my laboratory here, we make small ribbons which look like this. They're 20 microns in thickness, and so they're very thin. The heat is extracted very fast, and then these ribbons can be wound up to form toroidal cores for power electronic components. And the small ribbons, we can make power electronic components for computers and for electronics and whatnot. At the large scale, we make them for large power applications. So big power transformers, big motors, big inductive components that a variety of industries would look at. And so we've learned how to scale these alloys up to industrial sizes, and we're collaborating with NASA Glenn on that. They have a caster on site, and they cast these amorphous metal ribbons. And then we've got a process where we take an amorphous metal ribbon like you saw here, and we make what's called a nanocomposite. And what we do is we partially crystallize that material, and we can do that under a strain field. And what that allows us to do is tune the magnetic properties even further, and allows us to make very efficient magnetic materials. So in a magnetic material for power applications, you want to take magnetization, which is a vector, and switch it back and forth in direction. And every time it switches, there's some loss. And if you can limit that loss, you can make the component much, much smaller. These magnetic materials, because of their higher efficiency, and in particular their lower magnetic losses at high frequencies, allow you to decrease, scale down the size of typical components at a given power level by as much as a factor of 100 or so, and they're quite important. So you could imagine if you drive past a power transformer on the side of a freeway, they typically take up acres of room. If you scale that down by a factor of 100, you can take that same transformer and put it on the top of a Walmart or a Giant Eagle. And so that's important for distributing power in this country.